Hi friends, myself Neha Gupta and I'm back with the current affairs for October 13, 2020. But today I will be doing a different thing in the beginning. I will be introducing myself to you guys. You should also know about the qualifications of your mentor. So I have done my graduation from Delhi University in English Literature. Then I have pursued my master's in English Literature from IGNU University and I have been a mentor of current affairs for more than 1 year now. And with this, my introduction ends here and I will be introducing you with the news items that we are going to cover in this video today. So today I have a total number of 9 news which are very important and I will be quickly jumping on to the index page but will not waste a long amount of time there. We will be quickly covering that index page and then we will be discussing the questions in detail. So without wasting any time, let's begin the video. But before that, do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification. And also join the Telegram channel where you can ask your doubts and join with your mentors. So here comes our page of content, table of content. So first is the military weapon which is named as Rustam 2. Then Rudram first, it is again a military weapon and it has been, both these weapons have been recently test fired. That is why they are very important. India's first company to manufacture calcium nitrate. What is calcium nitrate? Why is it so important for us? That we will be discussing in the third question. India's first advanced manufacturing hub, quite important from the name itself. Indian Navy and Indian Coast Guard's joint exercise, quite important again. Ministry of Labour's expert group. So recently an expert group has been formed by Ministry of Labour. So what is the purpose? What are the things that the group is going to do? These are the things that we will be discussing in this question. Then we have the Director General of then we have Transform, which is India's first ever indigenous badminton racket brand. The name itself, the title is again suggesting the importance of this news. Then we have Director General of Bureau of Civil Aviation Security. And lastly, we will be discussing French Open 2020, which has concluded yesterday only. So come on, let's discuss the first question of the day. So the first question is, recently DRDO has successfully tested indigenously developed Rustam 2 weapon in Karnataka. What kind of weapon is this Rustam 2? So what are the options? Drone, nuclear missile, assault rifle, hypersonic missile or cruise missile. So out of these 5 options, our answer is drone. Quite an intriguing question it is, I know. But this is how the questions are being put up in the examinations nowadays. That is why I repeatedly say that you need to pick out the minute details. So what is the minute detail? It is the type of weapon that Rustam is. So Rustam 2 is a drone. Now this is the second version of Rustam. So obviously there would be a first version of Rustam as well. So what was it? Rustam first was an unmanned aerial vehicle which was commissioned in 2012 by India. So that is all we need to keep in mind about Rustam 1. And what is the things that we need to keep in mind about Rustam 2? First, that it is a drone. Second, it has been developed by DRDO. So these are the things that you need to pay attention to. Now my question for you guys is that who is the chief of DRDO? That you have to tell me in the comment section below. And here comes our next question, which is about, on which fighter jet is the Rudram first, which is India's first indigenous new generation anti-radiation missile, short form as NGARM, test fired. So what is the question asking you? The question is asking you about the fighter jet on which this this Rudram first missile has been test fired. So here again you can see the minority or the minuscule information from which the question has been framed. So let's discuss the answer of this question first and then we will be discussing about this missile type. So the answer of this question is option D, Sukhoi 30 MKI. So what is this Rudram first missile? Rudram first missile is the India's first indigenous new generation anti-radiation missile. That is the thing that you need to keep in mind about Rudram first. You don't need to go into the details or the understand the functionality of Rudram first, because that is not going to be asked from you in any examination. Only that it is India's first indigenous new generation anti-radiation missile, and it has been developed by DRDO. These two are the things that you need to remember about Rudram first, apart from the fighter jet. Now let's discuss something about Sukhoi 30 MKI. So Sukhoi is developed by Russia's Sukhoi company. And in India, this fighter jets are manufactured by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. So the license has been given by Sukhoi, which is in Russia, to HAL to produce these Sukhoi 30 MKI for Indian Army in India itself. So that is the thing that you need to keep in mind about Rudram first. And here comes our third question of the day. So the third question is, which company has announced to produce indigenous calcium nitrate and become the first country in India to manufacture calcium nitrate? First of all, we are talking about calcium nitrate, then we should understand what it is and what is the use. So calcium nitrate is a fertilizer which is widely used in horticulture crops in India. So these are the minuscule informations that you need to keep in mind about calcium nitrate. First, fertilizer. Second, widely used in horticulture crops in India. Now the third thing that you need to understand is that until now, till this date, India has been importing calcium nitrate from other countries, because India did not have that infrastructure, or we can say no company had taken that initiative to produce calcium nitrate in India itself. But now a company has come up and it has announced to manufacture calcium nitrate. So guys, can you guess which company is this? The answer is Gujarat State Fertilizers and Chemicals. So these are the information, these are the details that you need to keep in mind regarding this news. And here comes our fourth question of the day, which is about an Indian agency which is named as Guidance, has partnered with World Economic Forum to establish India's first advanced manufacturing hub. In which state will it be established? First of all, the thing that we need to pay attention to is that the purpose of this advanced manufacturing hub, because if we understand why is this being established, only then we can have a broader idea of the things that are going on. So what is the purpose? Clearly, it is clearly conveyed from the name or from the title that it is India's first advanced manufacturing hub. So what could be the purpose? Can you guess? Quite easy to guess. To promote manufacturing through advanced technology. Promote manufacturing through advanced technology. So that is the one line purpose of this advanced manufacturing hub, which is India's first. Now let's discuss the answer of this question. So can you guess which state is it? It is Tamil Nadu. Now an interesting point about Tamil Nadu is that Guidance is also headquartered in Tamil Nadu. So here you can link this thing that since Guidance is located in Tamil Nadu and it has partnered with World Economic Forum, then it is quite obvious that the state in which this hub is going to be established is Tamil Nadu. So here all the things regarding this question has been discussed. Now my question to you is that you have to tell me, where is the headquarters of World Economic Forum? That is your question for the day. And we will be moving on to our next question. So the next question is, what is the name of the exercise that was recently conducted by Indian Navy and Indian Coast Guard along Kerala and Karnataka coast? So what is the answer? Can you guess? Is it Matla Abhiyan, Aparang, Sagar Kavach, Varuna, Samudra Shakti? The answer to this question is option C, Sagar Kavach. This is the exercise that is conducted by Indian Navy and Indian Coast Guard, and it has been recently concluded along Kerala and Karnataka coast. So these are the informations that you need to keep in mind about this news. This is the one line news that we have for the phase one point, from the phase one point of view. Now guys, my question to you is that you have to tell me that what are the names of other exercises that Indian Navy conduct with Indian Coast Guard. So I hope that you have got my question. I'm asking you about Navy and Indian Coast Guard's military exercises. So you have to tell me the answers of this question and the questions that I have asked you earlier in the session. And we have come to our next question, which is very important from the exam point of view. Why? Because central government is involved in this. A new committee has been formed and we are talking about three new surveys. So do listen to me very carefully in this question. Who heads the expert panel formed by Ministry of Labour for providing technical guidance to Labour Bureau with respect to surveys on migration, professional bodies, domestic workers and other surveys? So clearly, we have been provided with the purpose in the question itself. What is the purpose? To guide Labour Bureau about the technicalities for conducting migration, professional bodies, domestic workers surveys. Don't worry, we will be discussing about the surveys in detail, but first I will be telling you the answer of this question. So the answer is option D, S.P. Mukherjee. So he is the head of this expert panel. Now, what are these surveys that are being talked about? These surveys will be conducted by Labour Bureau. So you have to keep in mind this thing. Labour Bureau is going to conduct migration, domestic workers and professional bodies survey. Now, what is the purpose of this survey? To assess the unemployment status of India. In order to gather the information about unemployment in India, especially during COVID-19 times, these three surveys will be conducted by Labour Bureau. Migration survey will tell us about the level of unemployment that migrants are facing. Domestic workers survey will tell us about the number of people employed in domestic work as well as those who are unemployed. Apart from this, we have professional bodies survey. What are the professional bodies? Professional bodies are like CA, doctors, lawyers. So these are the professionals. So how many people are engaged in professions and how many are not? How many professionals are there in India who are already educated, who have attained their degrees, but yet they are unemployed? So basic purpose is to assess unemployment, particularly during the time of COVID. Why I am saying this thing repeatedly, particularly during the time of COVID? The reason is that COVID-19 crisis has rendered many people workless, has snatched the jobs of many professionals as well. That is why, in order to assess the unemployment during COVID, these three surveys will be conducted by Labour Bureau, and the technicalities and operational guidelines will be provided by S.P. Mukherjee expert panel. Do remember these things that I have told you about this news. And now my question is that who is the Minister of Ministry of Labour? That you have to tell me in the comment section below. And here comes our next question, which is about who has been appointed as the brand ambassador of Transform. Transform is India's first ever indigenous badminton racket brand. Quite easy, no need for any explanation. It is very easy to understand. The name is Transform, and Transform is India's first indigenous badminton racket brand. So now we will be quickly discussing the brand ambassador. So who is the brand ambassador? It is Chetan Anand. He is a very famous tennis player and he has been appointed as the brand ambassador. Next question that we have is, who has been appointed as the Director General of the Bureau of Civil Aviation Security? Firstly, what is this BCAS? Why is it important? The reason is that Aircraft Amendment Bill 2020 has accorded a statutory status to BCAS, the Bureau of Civil Aviation Security. That is why BCAS is very important, because it is in the news, and recently a bill has been passed for this. So that is why, so this is the reason we need to remember this news as well. Now, who is the Director General? It is M.A. Ganapathy. So he is the Director General of BCAS. You have to remember this thing, and you have to tell me that who is the Minister of Civil Aviation Ministry. And here comes our last question of the day, which is very important again. Why? First of all, it is about French Open. French Open is among the four Grand Slam tournaments that are being conducted by International Tennis Federation. So guys, can you tell me that which four tournaments are we talking about? What is the names of those tournaments? Do find out about this thing. This is your homework for the day. You have to tell me what are the four Grand Slam tournaments, out of which one is French Open. So the rest is three that you have to find out. Now, what is the peculiar thing about French Open is, the thing is that it is also known as Roland Garros. This tournament is also known as Roland Garros. Why is it known as Roland Garros? The reason is because this French Open tournament is held in Roland Garros Stadium in France. Do remember this thing. This is the minute detail that can be asked in the examination. So now let's move on to the answer of this question, because we have discussed the background of French Open, and do not forget to mention that what are the other three Grand Slam tournaments that I was talking about. Now the answer to this question is, option E, Iga Swiatek. She is from Poland. Again, the minute detail that we need to keep in mind. So she has won the women's single. Now the other aspect of this question is the men's winner. So who is the winner of men's single? Can you guess? The answer is Rafael Nadal. So he is the winner of the men's single. And which country does he belong to? Guys, can you tell me this thing? He belongs to Spain. He is a very famous tennis player. So you have to remember this thing, that he belongs to Spain, and he has won the French Open 2020 in men's single category. And here comes our session to an end. We have discussed all the important news of the day. I hope that you have liked the session, and if you have really liked it, then do subscribe to our channel and like this video. Thank you so much.